Hello, hello, everybody. It's 5:04 p.m. Central Time on the 2nd of January, 2024. Got you here. We're looking at some geopolymer that I've made and I've put into some awesome molds. So if you're not aware of what geopolymer is, it's man-made stone. And it's poured like concrete. And in many cases, it's stronger than concrete. But it's limestone in this case, poured limestone. And just doing some test molds to see how things turn out. Incredible stuff here. And it's about as strong as concrete as it is right now. Great for indoor uses. And if we want to make an outdoor mix, I'll be getting that out at some point. But this is great for like mantelpieces, lamps, tabletops, tile, decorative art, frames, just all sorts of uses that you can use this for. Again, it's man-made limestone. So when it hardens, it looks like that. Now I'm gonna give you the mix if you wanna make it yourself. So I'll give you the mix. You can do this, you can play around with the ratios and so forth if you wanna make your own. And it's pretty easy to make. Non-toxic materials, so, and all stuff you can just get either on Amazon or from the hardware store or craft store. So 1 cup of salt water is where we start out. So I used tap water, and then I added in 1 tablespoon of Himalayan salt, or just table salt you could also use. So 1 cup of salt water, 1 cup of sodium silicate water glass, mixed into the water. So you take the water, you add the sodium silicate water glass, 1 cup of that. Then 1 cup of sodium carbonate, white powdered sodium carbonate. And you then add 1 cup of calcium carbonate, white powder. Then, final step, add 1 to 1.5 cups of crushed limestone. What'll start to happen is you'll feel it heat up as you add those ingredients in, and you do it in that mix. So let's recap. 1 cup of salt water, 1 cup of sodium silicate water glass, 1 cup of sodium carbonate white powder, 1 cup of calcium carbonate white powder, and 1 to 1.5 cups of limestone powder. And you'll get a mix like this for indoor use. It's going to be great for mantles, lamps, picture frames, furniture. It's as strong as concrete, compression-wise. And I'll link the Texas A&M University study on metakaolin geopolymers and how they're actually going to be replacing concrete at some point. You can also add in pigments. You can add in aggregates, other stones, if you want. It'll bind to wood, it'll bind to plastics, it'll bind to other concrete and other geopolymers. You can pour right on top. I used candy molds and ice cube molds to make these. And it really is stone. You could throw these against a wall and it chip just a little bit. This one's sealed. This one's not sealed. I sealed it using more water glass or sodium silicate, and able to make carnations. I mean, look at this. Roses. All sorts of, I mean, this one, I just really like this. So, I mean, imagine what you, the sky's the limit. You can pour huge pours with this. There's hardly any shrinking or expansion. So it just, whatever you pour, it just kind of hardens off that way and doesn't grow or shrink. I didn't get any cracking or expansion or contraction on any of the pours that I did on any of these. These are some ashtrays that I messed up. So I got bubbles in this one. So that one's kind of screwed. And I pulled it out too early and it kind of broke. Stuck to the edges. I pulled it out within like 30 minutes of pouring. I should have waited a couple hours. I was so anxious to see what this one looked like. But anyway, when you seal it, it looks like what you would think limestone you know, looks like, obviously. And when unsealed, it's really bright, like that real bright white limestone. So sky's the limit. Duchess is going crazy on this stuff. She wants to do all kinds of stuff with it. As an artist, you can paint with this stuff. You can actually turn it into a paint and paint with stone. So anyway, I'm gonna upload this video. We'll get it out on YouTube so you can watch it back. This is my geopolymer video for people who want to do their own. You can add in pigments. Yeah, you can add in all kinds of stuff. We could go on for hours on the stuff that you could put into this. Glow in the dark, you can mix in. You can even grow crystals in this stuff or on this stuff, but you can grow the crystals in the liquid mix while it's going, while it's drying. So if it dries within 6 hours, you can grow some crystals pretty quick. Others might take a few days to grow on the outside. Word up, much love. Go ahead and make your own, play around with it. You can play around with the ratios on what I just gave you as ingredient list, and you can also add stuff in. At the end, at the last step, instead of doing limestone, you can do other kinds of rock crushed to make other kinds of rock or similar looking rock. You would be making your own man-made stone, so there is no name for it. If you combine materials and make something new, you have to actually probably come up with a name for it if somebody else hasn't done it already. Anyway, I foresee the uses on these. Like, you could put these on four sides of a picture frame and then connect with filigree in between, which we have pores that we can do for that. Just one use of many, right? Like, you can make, imagine doing your whole kitchen with backsplash with these. A bunch of different flowers across your whole kitchen backsplash. Three-dimensional solid stone. One final thing I'm going to point out, this stuff can be used as mortar between things. It's super sticky, and it's just as strong as grout. So you can use it as a mortar or a grout in between tiles. You can also make tiles out of it to walk on. All right, anyway, you wouldn't believe the amount of forms that the Duchess and I bought for each other. Forms and molds. It was like a form and mold Christmas gifting special between each other. We've got so much stuff we're going to be pouring, it's not even funny. Balustrades, mantle pieces, big stuff we're going to be doing with this, not just the small stuff like this. These could just be little decorative pieces that are put onto, you know, for instance, a balustrade and railing in a house made of this limestone, poured in whatever shape we want, and then lined with ornate pieces. We're going to be doing that in our house. Now that I can pour and make anything out of stone, I think I'm going to be making a lot of stuff out of stone. I was also thinking about things that you can make out of stone that people haven't normally thought of making out of stone. So like an iPhone case, or like a computer case for your tower. Right? Wouldn't that be cool to get a computer case made out of stone? I think it would be cool, right? Just stuff that you would never normally make out of stone that you can make out of stone with this stuff. Sky's the limit when it comes to that. How about a computer keyboard? Why not? Why not a stone computer keyboard? I'll get the keyboard mold and I'll pour it. And then just get the electronics, put it on the inside, pour each key. There you go. One-of-a-kind stone keyboards. We're redefining what it means to be getting stoned. Although I could see some hippies probably coming up with uses for this stuff too, right? Bro, you can make a bong out of it, man. All right, much love, guys. Peace out. I'm going to upload this as a short video, 10 minutes long, over on YouTube.